Hello. Good morning to all of you. Today we start the insect entanglement. Entanglement almost present in all the organisms, which is the outermost covering of the animal. In insect, the outer covering or cuticle plus epidermal cells that secretes the cuticle is called entanglement. Many of the characteristics that make insect unique are attributable to the entanglement, which is mainly composed of cuticle, epidermis, and basement membrane. Cuticle is further divided into epicuticle, is the outermost part. Exocuticle is the middle part of the cuticle, and the endocuticle is the inner part of the cuticle, and epidermal cells and basement membrane. Thus, these are the five layers. Entanglement protects the internal organs and tissues. It acts as a protective barrier against entry of pathogens, pesticides, parasites, and predators. It is preventive barrier against water loss. It provides for the insect the sensory window of the outside world. Also lines the trachea, tracheole, salivary gland, and portion of reproductive tract. At the mold, all of this is shed. Protective barrier for foregut and hindgut. Entanglement functions in locomotion, feeding, excretion, protection from desiccation, and breathing. Here is the entanglement, the insect entanglement. This is the outermost layer of the cuticle, that is known as epicuticle. This one is the middle layer of cuticle, that is known as exocuticle. This is the inner cuticle, known as endocuticle. So this is the cuticle. This is the base epidermal cells, known as epidermis, or here is the basement layer is also present. The detailed structure of the cuticle entanglement. Here is epicuticle is the outermost part, exocuticle is the middle part of the cuticle, endocuticle is the most prominent part of the cuticle. So here is the cuticle, then a cemate layer and epidermis, epidermal cells form the epidermis or the basement membrane known as the basal lamina. This part is further divided into different layers, means a part of exocuticle or a part of the epicuticle. It is deliberately described here. There's the outermost layer is known as cement layer, then below cement layer is the wax layer. It is not necessary that this layer is present in all the insect. And some of the insect have cement layer or some of the not. Second one is the wax layer, then the outer epicuticle. There is the inner epicuticle, wax canal or wax filaments. Here is the exocuticle or the pore canals. Pore canals are the broader than the wax canal filaments. Immature insects are able to encapsulate certain parasites and get rid of them at the molds. At the mold, these parasites are expelled with the old exocuticle, means during the molting. Evolutionary significance is of two types, positive effect and negative effect. Positive effect, the characteristics which I have earlier studied by us, prevention of water loss because of the wax layer and cuticular composition is smaller than the organism the greater the amount of surface area per unit volume, greater tendency to water loss. Water ज्यादा surface हो area होगा तो water loss ज्यादा होगा. Preventive barriers for pathogens, parasites and predators. Negative impact, negative effect. As size increases, problems with cuticle being too heavy and also gaseous exchange, oxygen uptake adversely affected evolutionary experiment with mega neurons shows that cuticle is responsible for smaller size of insect. Structure of cuticle. The cuticle in all insects, there is a thin layer of cuticle with special properties and is composed of the epicuticle, exocuticle and endocuticle. The most thin layer is about 1 micrometer in the present in hindgut and over the gills of Epimeroptera larva. और अगर मोटाई देखते हैं तो मोटी कहाँ तक हो सकती है, 200 माइक्रोमीटर तक, जो कि पोलियोप्टेरा के इलेक्ट्रा के अंदर मतलब फोर विंग्स पे देखने को मिलती है. देयर इज ऑलवेज एन एपिक्यूटिकल लेयर एंड द एपिडर्मल सेल लेयर, बट द एक्सोक्यूटिकल एंड एंडोक्यूटिकल मे बी ग्रेटली रिड्यूस्ड और एब्सेंट इन पर्टिकुलर पार्ट ऑफ द क्यूटिकल ऑफ द सेम और डिफरेंट इंसेक्ट. The epicuticle. This one is the outermost layer. Yes, just that. The epicuticle complex and the outermost layer, and probably the most important layer, responsible for waterproofing and general impermeability of cuticle, produced by epidermis and dermal glands. Insects needing a renewable layer, soil-dwelling insects due to erosion of the cuticle by abrasion. As the significance of each layer of epicuticle, which each layer, 5 to 6 layers are present in the epicuticle as earlier described by us. Cement layer, this is the outermost layer closely associated with next layer and many serve and may serve to protect it. Not found in all insects. It is not necessary to present in all the insects, but may be present or absent. The second layer, the wax layer. Hydrocarbon constitute 90% of this layer, important to insects for water loss, thus waterproofing of cuticle in some Fulgoridae and scale insects. The insect produces a large bloom of wax on the outside. Bees have a special gland, means wax gland, on ventral abdominal segment 4 to 7 that produces wax, which is then formed into flax used by the bees to make their cells. Here's the again integument. The cuticle is divided into two parts, procuticle and epicuticle. Procuticle again divided into two parts, exocuticle and endocuticle. Thus, epicuticle, exocuticle, endocuticle, and epidermal layer. The outer epicuticle, cuticulin. Is a very thin layer of protein about 0.0075 micrometer thick, which is the typical thickness of an animal cell membrane. It is impregnated with lipids, some of which may be covalently bound to protein as lipoproteins. The first layer formed following the molt and is the layer that protect the new protein cuticle from digestion by molting enzymes, that is chitinase and proteinase, also called cuticulin layer. Outer epicuticle is also known as cuticulin layer. Inner epicuticle function is not clear, but it is a much thicker layer, 1 micrometer, than the outer epicuticle. Fourth one, wax canal filaments. A filament of wax that is produced by the hypodermal cells and extend to the inner part of the epicuticle. Wax channels are about 0.006 micrometer to 0.013 micrometer in diameter that are 10 to 20 times smaller than the pore canals. Next one is the pore canals. Tiny pores that runs from the hypodermal cells to the inner part of the inner epicuticle layer. Inside the canals, the wax filaments that extend up to the epicuticular layer probably serve as transport passages for wax from hypodermal cells up to wax layer. Pore canals are passageways from 0.1 micrometer to 0.15 micrometer diameter, extending from the epidermal cells through the endo and exocuticle. The pore canals can be very numerous. For example, 1.2 × 10^106 per mm square in some cockroaches, or as few as 15,000 per mm square in flesh flies. These are the number of pore canals. The exocuticle. The exocuticle contains chitin and protein. It lies just beneath the epicuticle. It is highly sclerotized and is therefore hard and rigid. Layers within the exocuticle may reflect light in such a way to produce a structural color in some insects. Many of the iridescent greens and blues of insects are structural colors due to reflected light rather than to pigments. The thickness of the exocuticle is variable and species specific. Adult insects generally have a thicker and more sclerotized exocuticle than larval insect. Regions in which the cross-linking occurs to give cuticle hardness. Regions do not break down by protease at all and is what usually remains in the form of exudate. Melanin and other pigments found in this area, sclerotization mainly occurs here. Also arthropodine and sclerotin proteins are present there. Cross sections of on co-peltas showing exocuticle. The endocuticle. The endocuticle is continuously being synthesized in a dark and light way, 24 hours. It's continuously being synthesized. So we shouldn't be considered. And often is laid down in layers. Thus, can often be used to age grade some insects. Contain most of the chitin, which is broken down at the molt by the chitinase. Little cross-linking of protein, thus most of the broken down at molting and reabsorbed in soft-bodied insects and regions of flexibility. In the intersegmental membrane, flexibility, arthropodial membrane, that is intersegmental membrane. This layer is well-developed and not the exocuticle. The epidermis. A single layer of cells underlying the cuticle and is responsible for its production. It is only living portion of the integument that is ectodermal in origin. These cells can be modified to form dermal glands, sensory receptors, and oenocytes. Epidermal cells are involved in bone repair and can move from an area of undamaged cells into an area of destroyed cells. The sex pheromones in most females, Lepidoptera, is secreted by small patches of tall, columnar epidermal cells located beneath the cuticle and ventral intersegmental membrane in the 8th-9th segment of the abdomen. So it means epidermis is the only layer which is active in the integument, or cuticle is the dead layer of the integument or protective layer. The Golgi complex is prominent in epidermal cells. The main function of the Golgi body is the secretion. So various kinds of secretory functions are performed by the epidermal cells with the help of the Golgi body. And probably serve several functions in the following. process of secretory substance is necessary to synthesize cuticle, production of material for the plasma membrane of the cells, processing and packaging of lysozyme needed for the autophagy. Oenocytes are large prominent cells scattered among the epidermal cells and also clustered at spiracles near origin of larger trach and scattered among fat body cells. These cells are usually large polyploid and always have extensive tubular spooth and endoplasmic reticulum and well-developed plasma membrane reticular system. Their function is not very clear, but their morphology suggested that lipid secretion and lipid metabolism. Basement membrane or the basal lamina, mucopolysaccharide layers that is secreted by the hemocytes. It is penetrated by nerve and trachea going to hypodermis and is a selective barrier between hemolymph and epidermal cells. Hormones and other nutrients can pass through this selectively permeable layer to reach the hypodermal cells. It's important in the recognition of self. Thus, the insect blood cells do not recognize it as foreign. Molecules in the layer are charged and probably act like a molecular sieve. Extremely important in self-recognition and cuticular integrity. तो आज हम इसको यहीं ख़त्म करते हैं. कल हम केमिकल कंपोजिशन ऑफ क्यूटिकल और दूसरी रिमेनिंग पार्ट ऑफ द क्यूटिकल विल बी स्टडीड टुमारो. थैंक यू. थैंक्स अ लॉट.